Gamers on Games is sponsored in part by
Highest goes first, I guess.
Yep.
I have 11.
Two.
I have a 2. Okay.
Alright, every model has 2 actions. Basically, the way it works is the first number is movement, then close combat, range skill, strength, constitution, leadership, wounds, and then armor.
Okay.
You can run, it doubles the movement. For stalkers, when they run, they actually get to move 5 instead of 4.
That's really funny because my movement says 1. Because you're talking about the numbers that go down the side, right?
Yeah. When you run, you move 2.
Oh. So, okay, so instead of me moving 2, I move 4.
Correct. Which, I said these get to move 5 because they're a special ability. Special ability says it on the back side of every card.
There's so much room on the front side. Oh, that'd be high bloodhounds.
Mm-hmm.
Models with this special ability receive +1 movement when using the run action.
Right.
So, okay, so instead of being 1, it goes to 4 normally, but then 5 afterwards.
Correct.
Okay, alright. Okay, so I have initiative, so my guys have to go first?
Correct. Alright. You move these until line of sight, or you can reveal them if you want.
Okay, so if it's 4, is it 4 spaces, or is it 4 inches, or what?
It's 4 spaces, because basically, the lines on these aren't great. But like, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, you know, like the line is there.
Oh, the grading is supposed to be each
yes.
area? Holy crap, that is hard to make out.
Yes, it is.
Okay, so if my guy is here, that's a space.
Mm-hmm.
Wait, would this be a space and this is another space? To get over the hinge?
No, that's just 1 space.
That's all 1 space, it's just an extended grade. Okay, so anything that's a half is also the other half
is 1.
Where, okay.
Correct.
Alright, so kind of reveals who they are when you move 5 instead, though. I guess it doesn't matter, but
They're the ones that can move 5, the regular ones can't.
So 1, 2, 3, 4? I think that's 4. Can we call that 4?
4 would be there.
Oh, okay.
Because that's the edge of the line tile.
Okay. They'll just pile in. You know what? I'm just gonna do that. That'll. Because it's not like you're gonna be able to get far enough to open this door anyway.
No.
You guys aren't that fast.
No, the fastest they can move is, you know, they move at a 1.
So the most they can move is 4 if they run.
Yeah, models can make a movement up to their movement tile +1. So 1 + 1, 2 actions, 4 plus the hives, 5.
And run is your two actions, right? Or is run 1 action?
Run will be 1 to move 2.
Oh, so when these guys all move their 4, I actually have 1 more action with each. Or does run kind of...
Well, if you wanted to move the 4, that would be 2 actions.
That's my 2 actions. Okay, that's what I thought. I thought run was my 2 actions. Okay. No, that's what I was trying, just double checking. Okay. I mean, if you want to run right in my guy.
First guy is going to use an action to open your door. So initiative.
Okay. 1. I think you're going first.
I rolled 5. So that would indeed be it.
You should come open that door. I'm not saying it's a good idea. I'm just saying you should do that. Ability marker. Whoa, those are tiny.
Yes, they are.
Okay. You have another S here.
Yeah, I got stuck in my finger.
Oh, okay.
They're going on sentry.
The guys are going on sentry, or they're putting down sentry guns?
They're going on sentry.
So, that's Overwatch?
Pretty much.
Gotcha.
There you go. A model may use one action to enter sentry, place a sentry token next to the model to indicate its status. Models in sentry can hold off one action point, which cannot be increased by any means, to be used as a reaction during the enemy's activation phase. Following base actions may be used during a sentry action, shooting, close combat, and move.
So all you guys have gone?
Yes.
Okay. Alright, so if my guys are going to move through this thing, because I'm considering it, what is the rules for going through these?
Alright, so all the aliens have the P ability, so they can actually end their movement in it. You cannot draw a line of sight through them.
Okay.
So I cannot shoot through them, and, for example, the warriors who have the acid spell ability can't shoot out of it either.
Okay.
So you being here and me being here, nothing can draw a line of sight,
Nor can they be shot in the tube.
Correct.
Man. And so my guys can literally just occupy the tube and just friggin' hang out.
Which is what I did to my dad. Here we go, airmen. Airmen are treated like any other corridor tile with two exceptions. Only models on small bases can move through those tiles, and airmen tiles cannot be used to draw a line of sight on or through them. Airmen tiles count as a regular tile through which to move. Only models with the tiny P special skill may finish their activation on an airmen tile. A model must spend one action point to move through an airmen, as per the example below, which, you know, the marine model getting ready to crawl through the airmen. After using his run action, he moves two tiles. His move ends on the air vent tile, which is unallowed, so the model backs up to the last legal tile occupied. The next activation, the model uses a run again and makes it to the other side, because it took three to get... three is where it stopped, so to move fully through.
Okay. So let's see. I moved all them up to there.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, I think all my guys can actually pile into this vent. Although I guess they can't overlap, right? So I can put as many in there as I can fit?
In the case of air vents, I think you only put as many as you can actually line in there. Because the only exception is actual corridors. There's displacement and... other special rules, like the Hive Bloodhounds,
mm-hmm.
they have the ability where they can occupy the same tile as other figures, because you can only have a maximum amount of each in each tile.
By the way, I assume anything that's considered, what do they call it, infested tile is going to look like that, where it's all gumped up?
Yes.
Okay. Anything that looks like that, I've started building a nest. Counts as an invested tile.
Mm-hmm.
Okie dokie.
Yeah, tile occupation. Each tile has its own limit of models that can occupy, which is referred to as a tile occupation. Each tile in the game has capacity of 8 occupation points, depending on its base size. Each model reduces the number of occupation points on a tile by a certain number. Once the occupation points of a tile are reduced to 0, no more models can pass through or be placed on that tile. So small base is 1, medium is 2, large is 3, models without bases is 6, and acid damage take up 1.
Okay. Correct.
So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Like I said, literally it's 3 by 2.
Okay. Yeah, that's as far as my guys could have moved anyway, so. Alright,
so initiative again.
Initiative again. I rolled a 1 again.
Thank you.
See, if there are more infested tokens, like, having the stalkers would be nicer. But, for the infants, I mean. Oh, did you guys actually have to go around the crates?
No, I just... how I'm moving them.
So, that's your turn?
Mm-hmm.
Alright, so it's my guys?
Mm-hmm.
Alright, so I guess I can... And it's going to cost me one to move through this whole thing, right? Or is it one, two, three, and then...
Well, it's one, two, three, four, five.
Oh, okay.
Because these count as three, and these each are one.
One, okay.
So, like, if these two were here, mm-hmm. it'd be two.
Right.
And you have to use an action to enter event, so...
Alright, so it's going to be one to enter, two, three, four.
Mm-hmm. So the best you can do is make it halfway through the event.
Let's see here. Let's move these two in. Still in infested territory. Okay.
So initiative.
Yes! I get to go first! Okay, so... One, two, three, and then I get attack? Or no?
I don't know if you can attack from the vent. I think you have to fully exit the vent.
Can I not exit the vent because he's sitting right there?
Mm-hmm. You're spending one action to move through the vent.
Okay. Wait, I'm spending one action to finish up my movement through the vent, then one to attack?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, so then... Okay, so then he could go one, two, diagonal here to come out.
Mm-hmm.
And then still do, and then still perform an attack.
Which would...
I'm surprised the motion tracker doesn't do something for you.
Okay, accurate. Yeah, let's see the motion tracker. And is that a ping? That provides line of sight to all tiles within range of up to three for Burning Inferno.
So these guys are in reveal, and those are two infants. Mm-hmm. With them being infants, that's the ones that are bent over?
Nope, those are stalkers. Infants are the standing up ones.
Alright. Oh, who do I want to attack first? So let's do this. Let's have... Well, do I have to declare them both at the same time, or do I kind of do one and then do the other?
You can do one and do the other.
Okay, so we'll do him into here. We'll see what happens there. So, what do I have to roll? It's an infant. My close combat score is 15.
All right, so you're looking to roll 15 or under to score an attack.
I hit with a 4.
Okay. And it's claws or strength
10? Claws and teeth, strength 10.
Okay, armor 13, so I need to roll... I think I have to roll 13 or under.
Oh, okay.
It's,
Oh, it says rate of attack, so...
Rate of attack 1.
Nope, 2. For me? For the infants? It says rate of attack 2.
Alright, so you have to roll a second dice then.
Okay. Well, the first one we know hit.
Yeah, second one needs a CC test equal to the weapon.
6. So I hit twice.
Okay. So I got a...
And AVV is... I don't even know what that is, but...
Any vehicle.
Oh, okay. So, yeah, I can't hurt vehicles. Got it.
That's for, like, engaging the power loader and stuff like that.
Okay. Yeah, we're not worrying about that. Not yet. Okay, so, I hit you twice, and I guess that's about it. So you gotta roll 13 and under, and I kill you. Right?
If I roll over 13.
Oh, roll over 13. Mm-hmm. So come on! Ah, that's one of them. Alright, I guess I'll have the second one attack the smart gun.
Okay.
Because that's... Oh, it's right there. That's gonna be a hit. Because, again, a CC of 15.
Mm-hmm.
And that gun does not hit, so I only hit one.
And he's good.
Okay. Alright, those guys moved up, those guys moved up. Yeah, so those guys were all where they wanted to be. Does that guy actually have an incinerator?
Yes, he has a flamethrower.
No. It was more. Okay, so make sure that you get your guys in your own shot there.
That's also, he's the medic.
Oh, so you can bring that one guy back?
A model with the medic P special skill grants heal 4 to every friendly model on the same and adjacent tiles.
Okay.
Since you're, since he's engaged with him
mm-hmm.
in close combat, the only thing I have is my knife. So my close combat is 12. So I'm gonna roll 12 or under.
That'll be a hit.
Okay.
And I have to roll my armor under.
Well, what's your armor?
15. 13. Sorry.
His
armor's the last one, right?
Yes.
Yeah, 13.
Alright, so add 1 to that, because the combat knife is a strength 9, so okay. You get a plus 1 to your roll.
Okay, so I have 14 or less. Mm-hmm. 8. So I'm okay.
So this is first action, second action, try to knife you again.
I don't think that's good.
Nope, so 14.
Oh, so it's good enough, okay.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, is it heavy or fire too?
No, it's rate of fire 1. It's my second action to...
Oh, okay. Do it again. 19. That is not going to be good enough. However, I have that whole acid blood thing.
Yes.
Acid blood. So I roll, and on a 1 or a 5...
1 through 5,
excuse me.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to put 1 color acid on the board. 9.
Yeah. So he just...
He dies bloodless.
Yep, he dies.
My guy, my most of me.
Right, so the second one is going to do the same thing. I need 14s. It's a 6. Same thing.
I'm okay.
First save. Second action, 14, good again.
Not good enough. And.
No.
6. Man, it is really hard to do the one thing that they're supposed to be really good at. That means you only have a 25% chance of actually doing it. That's really low.
Yeah, with the knife, yeah, no.
No, I mean 25% chance of me spraying with acid.
Yeah.
And really, it feels like that should be way higher. Yeah, but I still got 2 for 1, so right now I'm actually pretty happy with that cost. Though I gotta admit, I'm having flashbacks to Space Hulk.
Okay. So, initiative.
Yep.
I need to go.
Yes!
Wow.
Save me.
Yep, this is really bringing back Space Hulk memories. What are you doing? Overwatch. Always Overwatch. Every time you think I'm not Overwatching, haha, I fooled you, I'm Overwatching. Now, is the Overwatch, is your sentry thing a case of once it goes off, it's over? Or is it a case of it's always on for until you're activating again?
Yeah, a model may use one action to enter sentry. Place a sentry token next to a model to indicate its status. Models in Sentry can hold off one action point, which cannot be increased by any means, to be used as a reaction During the enemy's activation phase, the following basic actions may be used. Tokens may not. Tokens are not used up as a reaction to opponent's actions must be used before the end of the game turn. The sentry action lasts until the end of the game turn.
So when you use it, you lose it, or it lasts to the end of the turn.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. All right, you might want to move the rule book. Because all your guys are gone, right?
Mm-hmm.
All right. So I guess we'll do this space by space to see if when you want to do something. Do you want to take a shot?
Well, since you moved into line of sight, I don't know if it gets revealed.
Okay. That's a stalker.
Mm-hmm.
So you want to take you want your sentry now, or what's your range on the pulse rifle? I mean, I figured it's a rifle. I figured it's either a case of it can hit anything it can see, or it's a case of it can hit, like, you know, at least two spaces away.
There's apparently no range. As long as I can draw a line of sight to it, that's fine.
Okay. So you want to take a shot?
Yeah, the range of a model's weapon... the range of a model's ranged weapon, unless stated otherwise, is unlimited.
Okay.
Which I think the only one that's limited...
It is probably the incinerator. Or shotgun, if they have them in this.
Yeah, there are some that have,
The shotgun secondary?
Yeah.
They're pulling a hex.
I don't think any of them do. Yeah, it's just a grenade launcher. Yeah, I'll take my shot there.
Okay.
Just in case I do kill him, he possibility of the acid splash, the acid damage.
Yeah, that's why I figured I'd do this space by space to be fair.
Mm-hmm. So I need 14 armor.
That's a hit.
That is actually... Yeah, general gains. Dice rolls that result in a natural, unmodified one are always successful. Armor or heal rolls cannot be made if the hit roll results in a natural one.
But I can make a dodge roll, because I have a dodge ability. Unless it says I can't make a dodge.
Yeah, after a model with dodge is hit with an attack roll on a d20, on a roll of 1 to 5, the model dodges the attack, and the attack has no effect. In this model, on a 6 to 20, the dodge fails. The model must then continue as if it was hit by normal. Dodge rolls cannot be made to avoid hits from flamethrower attacks.
Yep. So, doesn't say anything about being denied on a 1. Which doesn't matter, because it didn't result in anything, so he's still going to die. And we got to roll for acid blood. Let's see here. Stalker, same rule? Yeah, 1-5. Nope, I got 20, so no blood on that either. Which I guess is good, because that would have influenced what can happen. So his thing comes off.
Yep. Yeah, rolls of a natural 20 are always a failure. Any model that rolls a natural 20 for any skill test may spend no further action points in the game. Also, a player cannot use his or her model experience bonus rolls or roll a roll of 20.
Yeah, alright, so I can make it to there.
So 1, 2, 3.
Okay. And so he'll do that. Alright. And what the hell, we're gonna go for the gusto. So he's gonna pop out. Here.
Well, I would say the second.
Oh, yeah, okay.
He was here, I do my reaction.
Oh, right, yeah.
So. Wait, fire 3.
No!
I need another 14s.
1, 2.
All successes.
All are successes. Now I gotta roll for my armor saves.
It's strength 14, so. Take your...
My armor is 13.
Okay, yeah, my 14, yeah, minus 4 modifier.
Yeah, so okay, now I gotta make 9s or under. Yeah. Okay, that sounds a little more reasonable. 5, 4, 8. So all of them are made. So I'm gonna make my attack now. Yes? You're right there.
I'm gonna use the other ones.
Okay. There you go. Ready to fire 2? Or 1?
Ready to fire 1.
Okay.
Success. Strength 12.
I have armor 13.
So yeah, minus 1.
So 12 or under. 8. I live! And now I'm gonna do my attack, yes? Well, actually I'm gonna move 1 and then I'm gonna attack it. And I have 2, so give me another die. Close combat is 15. Both are hits.
Alright. And then strength.
Strength, wait a minute, 9.
There's the strength 9, then it's, yes, under the armor.
So it's probably going to add to your armor?
Yeah, like I said, you got plus so 1 when you tried the knife.
Right, so what's your armor?
13, so 14 and under.
Yeah. Roll high.
And that was... You hit twice, so I need
second. Yep. Show me that natural 20. 12 and 13.
Yep, good, because I need 14s.
Okay. Alright, so... the move and then the one attack, I guess, counts as 2 actions.
Mm-hmm.
Alright. And it's another infant. He's coming out. We'll put him here. Have him attack. Both are hits.
Same thing, since he said they're 9s, yep. I need 14s.
Good. 13.
And good.
Okay. And let's see here, I can get one more. Oh, that's right, he can actually come out. So, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, we'll have him one up there. Because he can climb through occupied tiles.
Mm-hmm.
And... You know what? Okay, so he came out. I'll come back to him in a minute. And he can get to there. So. Yep. No. So he missed. And we'll have the other one. Actually, who's more lightly armored? Him or him?
They all have the same armor.
Oh, really? Mm-hmm. And I'll go off this smart gun again. 7. So that's a hit.
Alright.
Air cold eye.
Strength.
10.
Alright, so no modifier, so I see 13 or under. He's good.
Damn. I cannot believe they all whiffed. Yeah, I guess that's gonna kind of be it. I guess I'm just relying on initiative now. If I don't get initiative, I'm pretty boned.
They gotta hurt.
2. Yeah, you're getting initiative.
5.
Man, I have not been able to get initiative since that first turn. Now, I assume because your guys are actually in close combat, they're pretty locked in there.
Nope, I can roll to disengage.
Oh, okay.
Model can try to disengage from combat. To do so, it must spend 1 action point to pass a CC skill test. If the test is successful, the model may move away from the enemy onto an adjacent tile as long as it's not occupied by an enemy model.
Now, is that disengagement per figure or... In general?
Per figure.
Oh, wow, okay.
So...
What happens if you fail it? Does your guy just stop and that's the end of his turn? Or is it just...
That uses his action, he has to continue to fight.
Okay. I thought it was a case of also if you fail, like, I get a free attack.
Yeah, it doesn't say that.
That sucks. Can't blame a guy for hoping. I'm feeling my aliens are a little nerfed here.
Try to disengage him.
12 or under. Man, you're just getting every roll you need, aren't you? And pulse rifle?
Yeah.
Okay.
Actually. Right. Can't use that yet. Alright, so I need a 14 or under.
working on Jot.
Strength 12.
And my armor is, this is Stalker.
Mm-hmm.
My armor is 10.
So, 8.
Yeah. Nope, he did. Wait, acid. Nope, I'm not going to get that lucky. Man! As I said, the one thing... You know what? Yafat Kodo is full of crap, because when he said that, you know, it's got an amazing defense mechanism, you don't dare kill it. No, apparently you do dare to kill it.
Alright, it's dying, it's just falling over and just dying.
Yeah, I guess.
Someone was in an alien resurrection when the aliens killed the one alien and built a hole in the floor.
Yeah, but...
Alright, so...
I thought we were playing aliens and not alien dumb. I don't know, I had something there and I lost it. Damn it, I had something for this!
It doesn't say that I have to make one for every model, so I just have to roll to disengage from close combat.
Okay.
So,
I would think it'd be one per model, to be honest, but...
We'll see if they do a roll update.
We'll see.
So I need close combat is 12. So 12 or under.
And he's got it. No!
He's stuck, so he's gonna stab the first one in front of him.
Yay! Who knows, I could survive this.
No. It's not. That's fine, I'll take the chance. Every model on the target tile receives an auto hit with a strength of 12. Alright, so each of the infant warriors need to roll 11 or less, as its strength, 13 minus 2 was 11, of which each alien stalker in turn needs to roll 8 or less for blade damage. So one dice to roll is 1.
And where did your marine have to roll? It's armor.
15? 13?
13.
So you're also rolling 11 or less.
Yeah.
Alright, I'll let you take care of your guy, and then I'll take care of my three, and I'll just roll all at once, and then just go boom.
So 11 or less. 8 then.
Spoosh! Okay, let's see if this actually goes in my favor. I doubt it.
So 2 11s and an
8. Oh, you know what? Let me actually re-roll that, just because it is two different numbers, yeah. So... this is the two will be for these guys. It's what, 12 and less?
11 or less.
Oh, yeah, so they're both dead.
Yep.
Roll for the acid.
I guess acid does matter. Oh, of course, now both acid.
So, you're gonna have to roll for two acids on him as well.
Oh, can they eat? Well, I feel like it's a place where the acid goes. And wait, my guys can actually be a subject to their own acid? That sounds sort of weird. Let me roll for the last guy. I gotta roll 8 or less.
Yep.
No. Doesn't matter, everyone's dead.
We'll roll for the acid blood for him as well. So that probably turn that entire, yeah, that entire like corridor into a giant hole.
That's acid's. Don't worry about it when if it comes up again.
Okay.
Alright, so. I think I don't think this guy went.
Nope, he's the one hasn't moved yet.
Yep.
Not gonna go anywhere, so he's gonna do two sentry actions. Basically just overwatch the hallway.
Gotcha.
Since you know, they barbecued their own guy to
to
clear out that hallway.
Alright, so now my guy's actually gonna go. Mm-hmm. 1, 2, 3, 4. Can my guys take sentry options or no?
Nope, they're general basic actions, 1 point each, or one action point. The following basic actions may be used during a sentry action: shooting, close combat, and move.
Oh, so if I take two sentry actions, I can actually move and attack as a thing.
Sentry actions can be used between the activation or actions of enemy models. Sentry tokens may not. Sentry tokens not used up as a reaction to opponent's actions must be used before the end of the game turn. So yeah.
Okay. So, you know, because I just don't want to have to break out all the frickin' tokens. Here and these guys all have two apiece.
Okay.
Just because it's going to be insane to dig them all out. And it's going to clutter the board to no end.
Okay.
So, okay.
Initiative.
Yeah, here, have a die. I just cannot win initiative, can I? Again, double sentry, and then all those are double sentry.
Okay. So initiative again.
You're gonna have to come to me, man. I can wait you out.
I know you can.
You're the one with the objective. I just have to kill you. That's gonna be a double move for you. So
yeah.
He doesn't get the sentry.
Nope, that's why they're pulling on them. So, here we go.
Yeah, but I can't run an attack. Because it takes both actions. That's really unfortunate for me because that really makes it very hard to close quickly and do what I need to get done, you know?
Well, yeah, it moved to full five. But if you did the...
I still can't... Even if I move full five, I still can't attack.
Well, I said that's if you move to full five. If you do...
Four. Well, it's still run action.
They said he automatically gets a plus one.
If I run. You have to, it only comes with a run action.
Yeah.
So
well, that's if you use both actions to go the full five. You use one run action to move three.
Yeah, I still can't get there with three. On three, I get one. Yeah, one here, two, and three. I guess I could get the attack. But I'm gonna get ripped up before I get.
Yeah.
Before I even get close. Again, so. Actually, everybody but him is double sentry.
Okay.
Let's try rolling this die instead. Yeah, that didn't do me a whole lot of good. Holy crap, I won initiative! And nobody has sentry anymore, right?
No,
it all got peeled off.
It's a new turn, yep. Because you didn't move right. Out to use, and I didn't. Since I already moved, yours
yeah.
Weren't going to do anything.
That's three.
Mm-hmm.
That gets him in. Get him here. Don't worry, I'll reveal him when he...
Mm-hmm.
Just kind of doing placement right now. The problem is I don't want to load up one tile because you'll just be like, I'm flame throwing that tile and lose everybody, you know? It's kind of a bitch thing. Alright, so he's going here, he's here. I got the two of them over here. And he doesn't get to attack. Yeah, I got nothing. So I got one attack out of this entire thing. My hope is that they live on the counterattack or tie you up. That's an auto hit.
That's an auto hit.
So and you can't dodge it.
Correct. But strength is I get a plus one, right?
Strength 10. Yeah, but you can't armor check it. You can't do anything about it. You can't dodge it. Well, you could dodge it if you have a dodge ability. Remember, that's why that was the only thing that saved me the last time was the fact that the stalker that you auto credited had to dodge.
The infants who have the 9.
What?
Also about the strength of the attack.
Yeah, but it doesn't matter. It's a case of I auto credited. It's an auto kill because you can't armor check it. That was the whole big deal about it. The reason that I could do it when you shot my stalker was because he has dodge, and I still failed. Yeah, because you can't armor check it. You can't heal it. Yep. Sploop. See, now you can go nuts with the incinerator because I'm going to lose those 3 goddamn guys.
So, two dice.
Oh, this is going to suck so much.
That's for you.
Because it's auto hit.
Yeah, it's
auto hit. I have to make on the 2 infants, I have to make
11s and an 8.
Right, thank you. Alright, so we're doing the 2 11s first. Neither one. They're dead. And the other one is a
8.
8. I really failed that with a 20. Where were you for initiative? Okay. Acid's on all 3. No.
Negative on all of them.
Yep. It just roasted. Okay. That was my move, and everybody else is double sentries. Whether or not to move up and roast your own guy alive.
Yeah, actually, it's gonna be the end of the turn, so I'll finish it again.
Okay. Here, have a die. 18.
5. So, you go.
Pulls back around sentry, and everyone else is double sentry.
Alright.
Yes, that's right, further towards the kill zone.
It's a natural one, so...
Double sentry on everything. Your turn. Well, you have to go to that generator room.
I'll have to have somebody make it to the elevator, and then I gotta override the
escape pod.
Yep. I gotta override the door. That's all I gotta do.
You still gotta get there. If you can't do both, and you can't just flamethrower an entire tile without seeing what's there, right?
Originally I could, but since you killed him first, no.
Oh, is that what he allows you to do, is just shoot shit blind?
Ping provides line of sight to all tiles within range of up to 3 from Burning Inferno, a special skill on the grenade strategy card only.
So you could have grenaded or flamethrowered.
Mm-hmm.
Oh. Man, it really was good luck that it came out first. I crippled you pretty badly.
Yeah, that's why I was looking at what the prerequisites for the Burning Inferno was, and then it was like, oh, something needs to ping. Yeah. Requires Marine Extraction Model with a flamethrower or a power loader. Every model on a target tile within a range of up to 2 tiles receives 1 auto hit for each rate of fire of the weapon and strength and or ABV equal to weapon strength and ABV. A marine armed with a flamethrower may use his or her shooting action to target a tile located around a corner without the need for line of sight if the targeted tile is within 3 tiles of marine model with the ping special skill.
Okay. Alright, so your guys just moved up. Are you moving them up anymore, or...?
Nope. They're gonna go there, and then...
Sentry up.
Yep, sentry up.
Which doesn't matter, because they're the last ones in the round anyway.
initiative again.
Yep. 4.
15.
Double sentry. Done. Go.
Well, I'm going to go first. I rolled 15, rolled 4.
Oh, right. Duh. Duh. Oh, my sentries are off then.
Yes.
No!
My sentries are off.
My tacos!
My most of me.
Two. Sentry on both.
So you went first. You already sentried up. I'm just going to sentry up again. There's nothing else for me to do. So, back to initiative. 3! 16! You say if I don't go my full movement, I can still attack after I run, right?
Yeah. So basically, one action would be to double your basic movement.
Mm-hmm.
And then your second action would be to attack.
Boop!
Alright, so...
He comes out, that's going to be an infant.
Yeah.
I assume you're going to overwatch me now. Kablamo, blamo!
Yeah, that's all I can do is just fire. It's gonna be electric, takes two actions.
Okay.
So, 14 or under. Got it. Strength 12.
Armor 13.
Minus 2.
To me?
Mm-hmm.
So 11 or less.
Correct. Because it's basically, it's over
10.
It's if it's a 10 strength, no modifier, anything above that, you subtract, anything under that, you add.
Okay. You might want to just keep that book, that page handy.
Yeah.
All right, so you overwatching him with the incinerator?
No.
Okay. As you from there. Actually, I'm adjacent, I can attack. I can attack him right off. Alright. Because I can't... I'd have to take one more step in order to reach her, so... or him. Whatever. The guy with the incinerator. I keep thinking it's Dietrich. Alright, let me do my thing. So, I get two attacks. Strength 10.
Oh, yeah, do the close combat skill first.
Oh, right, sorry. Close combat is, it's 15 apiece. So, one hit. Strength 10. Your armor is 13.
Yep, so no modifiers. I have to roll 13s or under. Good.
Okay. Let's do him. 1.
Alright, so...
Actually, here, 1.
With that one still being on that tile, that will do it. So auto hit, strength 12. You need 11s.
Twice or once?
The flamethrower is rate of fire 1.
Okay, so I need 11, you said?
Yeah.
Nope. And it won't matter for acid anyway, so why bother? Okay, that one's off.
That sentry action is done.
So. 3. Oh, I'm sorry. The stalker was actually coming around, coming through. Because I have 1 stalker left.
Yeah, I was doing the math. I was like, I figured there was 1 left.
Yeah. And then everybody else. Oh, actually. Sorry, I can actually get to here with 4. I can get behind you that way. I knew I had it figured out that I could pile everybody else in. I'm just gonna pile in here to here. That'll be my last 2. I figured at this point I can't stall anymore, I have to go for broke.
Yeah, which if you're putting that one there 4, that would be both movement actions.
Oh, wouldn't it? So he would have to deal back.
Mm-hmm. Remember, you can go three and attack.
Yeah, but if you use your flamethrower, you're gonna hit yourself. You're gonna potentially torch yourself. And I'm talking directly to your own actual flamethrower guy.
Yeah.
So this is gonna be kind of interesting anyway. It doesn't matter. So he missed. We're on to these two. We're gonna do them. I'm gonna do this one first, attacking the machine gunner or okay. The rifleman.
See the
one hit.
Okay, one hit. I need an unmodifier of under 13.
Good. And yeah, we'll have the other one attack the. Yeah, we're going after the machine gunner.
Okay.
And both of them. Oh no! Wait, one hit. One hit. I got a 14. One hit.
Okay. So 13. Nope.
Nope.
He dead.
Yay!
All right. So initiative.
10. Please roll crappy. I'm not gonna get that lucky.
All right. So I need to make a
roll to disengage.
Roll to disengage. Close combat is 12. No.
So she's stuck. Knife?
Yeah, I'll knife the stalker.
Okay.
Alright, now there's a better chance of dodging. I'll knife the infant in front of me.
Okay.
So, you gotta make a 12 or better. Did. Or 12 or under. You get a plus 1 to your armor.
So, 14 or less. With a 19, that's not happening.
Acid.
Acid. Does actually matter. Nope. I really feel like the acid should be much more of a prevalent thing. It's way too rare that it ever happens. Alright. Everyone's just piling in anyway. And they're all going to attack. The only nice thing is the Stalker gets to attack twice because he's already there.
Yeah, you're not going to be moving.
Yeah. So, you know what? Actually, let's do the Stalker first. Close combat of 10.
Seven.
So that's one hit.
One.
One. So he's got one hit. Strength 10.
13, so I just roll 13 and under.
Nope.
Dead.
Yay! Woohoo! The Gene Stealers, I mean Aliens, won!
I almost came down to they almost didn't.
Yeah, but that was a case of I really had to pile them in. I really had to get them in.
I figured you were going to do that once I got to about here. You're just going to like flood the hallway so that way.
It's all I can do.
No.
Their strength is numbers. Because unfortunately, the rules for. Me moving around and staying out of the line of fire is really even with
the auto hit. I could have maybe killed, I could have killed all of them. I could have killed one or two
or none. Yeah.
So if you
the flamethrower has been pretty wicked, but I was like, I've got to force it into a situation where he's either got to torch his own guys or torch himself to do this. And
if I was able to disengage, I would have backed up and then torched the entire tile.
I was banking on the not being able to disengage. I really feel like that also the disengage, it's a case of either the more people that are actually around him, it gets harder, or you have to make it for every guy. Because without a range attack of my own, it's very much a case of, I do have to play the waiting game, but the problem is if you decide that you're also going to play the waiting game, this game will go on forever. But you do have to make the objective. And well, actually in this case, objectives.
Yeah.
But I definitely can see how this is a case of, I was thinking, I was like, man, he's only got five. This is going to be, like, really kind of a slaughter. But it worked out that way because I killed the guy with the motion tracker right off the bat. Because you were like, I'm going to park him right in front of the vet. And I'm like, oh, wait, I'll go diagonals. Boop!
Well, all five marine tiles are all the same. So it really doesn't matter which ones. It just, I place which ones I want there.
Right.
It's the only case for the alien ones, the pictures actually depict what they are.
Yeah, well, it also matters because I got two very different guys sitting here.
Yeah.
I just find that really funny that I was like, I'm going to put him right here. Oh, okay. I guess I'm killing Hudson. It's game over, man. Game over. Because that's kind of what it came down to. Is if I hadn't killed him, there would have been so many different attacks where you're like, oh, I know there's something there. Torch the tile.
Yeah, as like I said, the flamethrower can do around corners, which is disgusting. If I had made it here with him still alive, when you came out here, it would have been everything in this entire area would have just been barbecued.
Yeah, including your own guys.
Well, saying that if I managed to get them out of here before you made it out of the...
Yeah, but you said anything of these two tiles would have been barbecued.
Yeah.
The best your guys could have done is get from this tile to this tile. No one would have been able, especially if your guys hop in here, there's no way they could have gotten through him.
Yeah.
So they would have had to hopefully not get barbecued. Yeah, that's one of those things where if it hits, if it's a attack, with these kind of games, especially if it's an attack that hits a whole tile, it's either really amazing or absolutely the worst possible thing you've got in your arsenal.
Yeah.
It depends on where people land.
Like, okay. If I managed to, I killed the one that was here and, kept them in this room.
Oh, yeah.
Just hit the tile and just... That's why the engine room.
That's why I double checked with my claimant. You can't hit that on whole tile right now, can you? And you're like, oh no, because I don't have the motion tracker. I'm like, oh, okay, no, I'm all right. But let me see the rule book for 1 second, because I'm curious. I figure they're going to give you pistols as well as part of your armament.
Gun, knife, combat knife, grenade launcher, pulse rifle. That's really it.
Combat knives. They really push the combat knives pretty hard.
Yeah.
No, there's no handguns. There is, that's the M30 auto cannon for the sentries.
Mm-hmm.
Hydraulic grapple, and flamethrower.
Actual power loader.
Yeah. But, yeah, most of the guys seem pretty universal. I would figure they would have given you guys at least a little bit more options, you know? Overcharged stun prod.
Yeah, I mean, you can assume what that is.
I assume that's the Praetorian.
No, that's the Queen.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Man, she's tiny. I mean, seriously, she's very tiny.
She takes up 4 tiles.
Yeah, what does, a Praetorian take up?
Same amount.
Really?
Yep,
really feels nerfed.
The Royal Guard or the Praetorian or the Predalien.
Oh, yeah, I forgot they have Predalians in this as well.
Yeah, but... You're assuming
Queen versus a trooper. I don't know, she always just seems so much bigger. Maybe she's not fully matured like she was in the movie. She's got those tiny little vestigial arms. I got these tiny, tiny little baby arms coming out of my chest. These things ain't ants, man.
Yeah, because
And you didn't do any of the predators yet?
No, they're they take up medium sized bases.
Oh, the predators take mediums?
Yeah.
That's weird. Wait, let me see that base again. And this is the same size as the base for her, right?
No, the base for them eclipses it.
Okay. Yeah, alright. For a second, I thought they were taking the same base. I'm like, come on!
Because they're larger figures.
Yeah, well, I figured they were going to be slightly larger. Well, They're like 6.5 to 7 feet tall, the predators.
Yeah.
I mean, they're bigger than a dude, but not, colossal. I mean, also, if you want to put it in scale, I mean, considering Arnold Schwarzenegger is, he's 5'10"? I think even I'm taller than him.
Yeah.
You know, and this thing is bigger than him, it's, maybe a little bit closer to my height.
Yeah, the difference between the actual warriors themselves and then the infants.